So are there microplastics in your chewing gum? Yeah, there probably are. Why are there microplastics in chewing gum? That is because a lot of gum is literally made with plastic. And I'm not saying like plastic is a byproduct used within the processing, which is totally the case. No. It like polyethylene, which is a form of plastic, is literally one of the ingredients. And I have been doing videos on this for years. Polyethylene is actually allowed as an ingredient in gum base. Even if a gum advertises itself as like natural, when you actually look on the ingredients in the back, a lot of the times it's going to say gum base. And that is just like a catch-all term for what could be any combination of like 10 to 20 different ingredients, okay? And one of those ingredients is polyethylene, which is literally a form of plastic. And there have been studies that I've talked about in the past that when you chew gum, it increases the amount of microplastics in your body. Study done last year that found that women that regularly chewing gum had higher amounts of microplastics in their body. And this specifically looked at the human endometrium, right? So that's the lining within the uterus. The reason that people are talking about this now is that there was just a press release about a new study that's about to be published, okay? I don't have all the data right now. I only have the press release, okay? So they tested 10 natural and synthetic gums. Somebody actually chewed it, and then they analyzed their saliva for microplastics. What's crazy is that pretty much every single type of gum, whether it was synthetic or not, released microplastics. Gnarly, right? We don't have data on like what types of gum they actually chewed. However, most studies like this, they usually don't include the brand names when they release this. I also want to mention though that I'm going to start testing things for microplastics, okay? So TikTok is probably going to go away within about a week. Again, regardless of what happens with this platform, I am on Instagram and I am on YouTube, and I'm going to start a Patreon because I have purchased an analytical polymer testing machine very similar to the one that they used in this study. I am going to start measuring microplastic contamination as well as which polymers exist within certain products, okay? So if you're interested in understanding more specifics and brand names, onto my YouTube and then my Patreon, that is going to be where you're going to be able to find this information.